Let S be universal set and A be a fixed subset of S if A union B equal to B holds for all subsets B of universal set S. Prove that A equal to phi. Okay. So, if possible, let A not equal to phi, and then we get a contradiction. So, we will prove A equal to phi. So, if possible, let A not equal to phi. So, obviously, there exists some element in A. Now, let X belongs to A. This implies X belongs to A union B, because A union B contains those elements such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Now, here X belongs to A, so obviously X belongs to A union B. This implies A union B equal to B holds for all subsets B. So, obviously X belongs to B by given condition. Because these two sets are equal, so obviously these two sets contain same element. So obviously X belongs to union B. This implies X belongs to B. X belongs to B for all subsets B in universal set S. So in S. Now, X belongs to A implies X belongs to B. Therefore, A subset of B for all subsets B in S. Now, X belongs to A. Therefore, A is non-empty set. We actually here assume A is non-empty. Now A is non-empty set, and A subset of B holds for all subsets B in S, implies that this implies that a non-empty set is a subset. A non-empty set is a subset of every set for all subset V, every set in a universal set. Now, this line implies that a non-empty set is a subset of every set in a universal set. So, this is not possible, which is not possible, because A is non-empty, but B can be phi. So, obviously, a non-empty set cannot be subset of empty set. Or we can say, suppose A is 1, 2, B is simply 1, then A cannot be subset of B. So, obviously, a non-empty set cannot be subset of every set. But here, we prove that a non-empty set is a subset of every set in universal set. So, this is not possible. Hence, our assumption is false. Therefore, A equal to phi. We assume A not equal to phi, which is false. Therefore, A equal to phi. And this is proved. If you like this video, please share, subscribe, and comment.